Hello, everyone. Welcome to another edition of Getting to Know You, the conversation with Lionel Berkin. And by this time, I hope everyone does know I am Lionel Berkin, so we can settle that. Today, we have a very special guest that we've looked forward to for a long time, and I've told so many people that I would have this person as a guest, and they keep asking me when. Today is when. And so, I'm very pleased to be able to introduce you our mayor, Meryl Frank, who by now has gotten to be known as the busiest mayor around here. And so it was very difficult to be able to schedule this program. So sit back and enjoy what we do have. Welcome, Meryl.
Thank you, Lionel. I'm happy to be here.
All right. Now, we know a lot about your activities and we see your activities, but we'd like to know a little bit more about you. So you don't mind, I'm going to ask you a few questions that maybe others have not.
Okay.
For example, where were you born?
I was born down at the shore in Ocean Township, New Jersey, and grew up there, and my parents still live there.
Really?
Yeah.
What town?
I grew up in Wayside, which is near Asbury Park and Neptune, and they're still in the same house.
And you went to school? Grade school and high school and all that good
went
stuff.
Went all through in Ocean Township, yeah.
During those days,
yeah.
Your activities in school, you certainly never expected to be mayor of Highland Park at that
no,
moment.
No, I didn't.
Right?
No, but I was involved in politics, and it's interesting. I was interviewed by Cablevision a few weeks ago, and the woman that interviewed me said, you know, I know you. And I said, how do you know me? And she said, she was on the environmental commission or something like that in Ocean Township where I grew up. And she said, you were mayor for a day. And I said, I was? And she said, yes, weren't you in the youth council or something? I said, yeah. And she said, I remember you. You were the mayor. And I realized, you know, I think I was. I had completely forgotten. But I was involved in student government and I was always interested in politics. But I never thought that I would be the politician. I went to school and studied policy. And so I was the behind the scenes person, you know, the people that get the job done. But it never occurred to me that I would be the politician.
Mm-hmm. So you never know. Sometimes
you never know.
Sometimes the expression is, don't wish too much, because sometimes what you wish for can come true.
That's right.
In your case, it wasn't even a wish.
No.
Tell me, as I understand, because we have talked, at the age of 16, you met somebody and you're still...
My husband. I met my husband when I was in high school.
Was he in high school too?
He was in college by then.
Okay, so
I was 16, he was 19, and we've been together ever since. It's 27 years, I'm 43, it's 27 years.
Yeah. So at an early age, you liked older men.
Yeah. I was dating his brother, that's how I met
him. Is that what I mean?
Yeah.
Oh, boy. Anyway, as a result of all this, you have how many children?
I have 4 children.
And they are?
Isaac is at the high school. He's 14. Eli is 11. Eve is 9. And Belle is 7.
So
two boys and 2 girls. Great kids.
So that in itself keeps you busy.
My other full-time job.
So you hold down 2 full-time jobs.
Yeah, it's a lot of work. But I have to give a lot of credit to my husband because he stepped in and took over. You know, I was an at-home mom for 12 years.
Ah.
And when I started doing this job, this is much more than full-time. He stepped in and has been there for them.
Oh, you're just plain lucky. You know, you can't guarantee you that stuff. You're
yeah.
just plain lucky.
It's,
right?
It's not easy. I still haven't figured out how to balance it all.
Huh.
I'm not sure I do a great job at that.
Well, the majority seem to think so. So
thank you. We'll have to ask my kids when they grow up.
Yeah, except it while you can still hear it.
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, dear. Your mom and dad still live in Neptune?
They live in Wayside, and they're in Florida in the winter, and they'll be coming up soon. But, yep, they're still there. And my husband's parents are still down there, too.
So
we have a shore mentality in our house. Yeah, we're big Bruce Springsteen fans, being from Asbury Park. And when we want to get away, we go to the beach. But, you know, if you're shore people, you don't go to the beach in the middle of the day. You go in the morning or you go in the evening?
See, I never had that.
Yeah?
No. I wasn't a shore person. And at the age of 9, I darn near drowned standing still in a freshwater pond, holding onto a boat. And while I stood still, I kept sinking into a mud hole, not knowing it, until I went down under. And all the kids rushed in and pulled me out. And they didn't know about artificial respiration.
Oh, boy.
All they know is to toss them around, beat them around, get the water out of them. And the result is, I was afraid of water. I didn't learn to swim till the age of 65.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
And now I go to the Y and I swim. So much for me and the water.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? Everybody has a story about something.
Yeah.
That was mine. Anyway, things that you can do when you have time to do them, things that you like to do. I know you confess to being an eBay fan of doing things on eBay, right?
Well, you know, when you have, my life is very busy, as I say. You know, I have 4 kids, and being a mayor is 7 days a week, and it's really 24 hours a day. It's days, it's evenings, weekends. And so what I do when I get home late at night to cool out is I go on the net and I go onto eBay. And that's what I do to relax.
No, that's right. I know so much about it, I've never been on.
Yeah. It's great. You can put anything in and it comes up. I got a couple of dishes from my mom that were my grandmother, Meryl's. And I turned over the dish and put the name of the dish in eBay and it all came up. And I've been able to fill out a set of dishes, my grandmother's, that were made from 1900 to 1916. And I've been able to find them there and fill out the set. Now I have a full set.
Terrific.
I get postcards of Highland Park, and I look for postcards of the Raritan River, and I found some interesting things.
Also, one of your pet hobbies, or if you want to call it that, is antiquing.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah.
Have you ever really found anything that was good, valuable, or
my
interesting?
My best antiquing story is actually in Highland Park. This was years ago. It was one of those block sales where the whole town sells garb, their garage sales. And I went around and I went to this woman's house, and she had a trunk, and in the trunk was a patchwork quilt. And I asked her how much it was. I said, "Oh, it's beautiful." She said, "Ah, my aunt made it." And she was an older woman, and I said, "Well, how much is it?" And she said, $250. And I said, $250? You know, that's a lot. Thinking she meant $250. And which for this quilt would not have been unreasonable. But it was just, I wasn't going to spend $250 on a quilt. And I opened up the quilt, and it was beautiful. And I said, "You know, that's a lot of money." And she said, $2.50? And I said,
"What?"
I said, "This is a really good quilt. You should be charging more for this." She said, "Ah, it's a piece of junk. My great aunt made it. It's junk. You can have it. $250. You want it?" And I said, "Okay." So I got this beautiful patchwork quilt with flowers, and it's absolutely beautiful for $2.50, even after I protested the price, saying it was too low. That's my best garage sale story. But I like antiquing. It's, you know, there's stories. Every item you pick up has a story to it.
Sure.
And I like
it. It means something to somebody.
It does. And you wonder what the story is. You wonder why it's there. I collect old menorahs.
Huh?
And you figure if they're for sale somewhere, there's a story. There's a story why a family doesn't have it. So I adopt them.
Very good. Very good. What kind of theater do you enjoy?
Theater.
Yeah.
I very rarely get to the theater, but I like it. I like going. I go to the movies a few times a year. And I just went to the theater, actually, for my birthday last month, for the first time in a couple of years, to New York, to the theater. I saw The Crucible with Liam Neeson. It was great. It was great. And I took my son, Isaac. He happened to be reading The Crucible in school, too, so it was great. But it's rare. I love going, but it's very rare that I actually get it. I do go in New Brunswick, and there's a lot of good theater in New Brunswick.
Drama, musical, or what?
I'll go for anything. There's only one thing that I hate. I hate Les Miserables. I hate that. I hate Phantom of the Opera. I hate. There's a few that I won't go to, or that I've been to and wanted to walk out. But
you remind me of somebody I know who has strong hates, not just I dislike, but I hate this, whatever it is, you know? I'm not gonna
Some people love that. I couldn't stand it.
Yeah.
I couldn't stand it.
Everybody has
I wish
choice.
I had time, you know, and I wish I had time to go in New Brunswick. We have great theater right here, and I just don't get a chance to go over. You know, I think everybody feels that way, and we should make more of an effort to take advantage of what's right here.
Sure.
Yeah. You know, we all lead, it's not my life is that unusual, we all lead busy lives. And it would be nice to be able to take the time to take advantage of everything that we have right in Highland Park and New Brunswick.
People either have to be spurred on or know more about it or stimulated somehow.
You get so caught in all the details
do.
Of your life, then,
it's
kids and
do.
Work and everything else.
It's hard to get people to move.
Mm-hmm.
And everybody says, I wish I could do this or I wish I could do that. Or, I wish I had time. And nothing happens.
Yeah.
First thing you know, it's a week later, a month later, or my God, a year later. You know, mm-hmm. things of that sort. And they haven't done it. But, hey. There's a limit to what you can do, right? So you try.
Yeah. Well, you know, I love my job, so that's what I do. And I don't feel like I'm missing out on other things. There's so many exciting mm-hmm. things that you can do there.
Oh, sure. Good grief. If you were not mayor, what would you be doing?
I would be being a mom, which is takes plenty of time. And I love photography. I think I would have been a photographer. Maybe a journalistic photographer. Or I love the art of photography.
And I assume that being the case, you probably have a nice collection of things that you have done.
I do.
So, too bad we don't have show and tell.
Yeah.
You know? I could show you photographs and say, see, shot by Meryl Frank,
mm-hmm.
whatever. Right? But hey, that's something you can do when you get to be a ripe old age and collect things and show what you've done aside from all your other activities.
Yeah.
Big photographic album. Right? Good. Anyway, this program flies by.
Yeah.
We think 15 minutes is long, and then we do it, and all of a sudden 15 minutes is gone. And we're now approaching a wind-up situation. And I know at one time you and I spoke for hours, right? As a matter of fact, our first broadcast, we spent more time than we had.
When I interviewed you.
That's right. And it just rolled on and on. And now I'm getting signals that time is passing and we're going to have to say goodbye very shortly.
Well, thank you for having me.
But I'm so glad that I was able to get you into this chair. Every time I heard, yeah, we have Meryl scheduled, but I can't guarantee it. Let's cross our fingers. And sure enough,
sorry,
we had the fit. So at least now we're here, okay? And we're going to wrap this up and hope that we'll have another session at some future date.
That would be wonderful.
Right? In the meantime, a lot of little things can happen, and we'll have places set, arranged for or made by or created by Mayor Frank, right, Mayor, that's what we'll have. And I'm afraid we're going to have to say farewell to this session, which has gone by so rapidly. I want to thank everybody for looking in and say we're going to take a break and we'll have a second half to this program, but we're going to have to say goodbye to Meryl Frank. So thank you very much for being here again.
Thank you for
having
me.
And I look forward to the next time that we'll be lucky enough to have you.
Sure.
Okay?
Thank you, Lionel.
And so, until the second half of our show starts, this is it for the moment. Good evening. Welcome once more to Getting to Know You. Lionel Berkin, and tonight you are in for a treat. We have a very charming, lovely personality. It's a lot of interesting things to talk about. And I'm not going to waste any of the time, because I so anxious to hear all that she has to say. And so I want to introduce you and everybody else to our charming guest, Ling Yang, who is from Highland Park, and most people have occasion to see her but don't realize what a charming person we have here. Now, I understand, and you correct me with everything, because I want you to tell me, you are from?
Fujian, China.
Fujian, China, which for people who don't really know, is located in what part of China?
It's very in the south, close about from the Taiwan.
In other words, in the southern part of China, not far across from Taiwan.
It's next to Guangzhou. Everybody know that. Yeah,
sure, because that's a popular place.
Yes.
All right. And you were raised there as a child and went to school there?
Yes. I finished the junior school and high school and college in China.
Uh-huh. Yes. And what kind of degree? What did you study as?
I'm studying Chinese. Yeah, the college I take 2 years, you know.
Mm-hmm. And your parents? Were they all the time, or did they come before you?
Oh, yes. But my father be American from 1981. So we got to move here from 1991. In my family came in together with my dad.
And how big a family do you have?
I have two sisters and brother, you know.
Two sisters?
Two sisters and old brother.
And how many brothers?
One brother.
Mm-hmm. So there are four of you all together.
Yes. We came same time, same day. Yes.
Where did you come to in the United States?
First step, New Jersey.
Really?
Yes.
How did that happen?
Because my father and my aunt, they live in New Jersey all the time, you know, whole life for her. So we came and visited her and my father, so we all in New Jersey now.
And when your father came here, what did he do?
He owned the Chinese restaurant, you know, for a couple of years. And when sometime he worked, in the Chinese brand, in the Highland Park.
Yes.
Yes, about 15 years ago, he worked there about 3 years. So he know the Highland Park, you know, very nice area. So when we came here, we live South Plainfield. So he still tried to make the other business in Highland Park. And we got first business is shoe store, the same location in Highland Park.
Wanna know?
From 1998 to 1999, only 1 year, and then we closed, you know. So now we do the other store.
Do you know I bought these shoes in your store? Really?
Yeah.
Floor shine shoe.
Yes.
I remember I bought it in your store.
Mm-hmm. Yes. We only make a year. And then, you know, so we change for the other store.
So now you have the store called Dollar City.
Dollar City.
Yeah. And you're married?
Yes. I'm married and I have two kids. One daughter, 7 years old, and one son, 2.5. And my daughter go to the school in the Irving School. Yes.
And your husband, you met here or you know him from China?
We know each other in China when we was in high school, because his parent and my parent, they was teachers in the same school. So we know that from parents, yes.
What did your parents teach?
They teach Chinese, they both teach Chinese. His mom teach, sometimes, you know, they teach the math and Chinese, the language in the Jewish school.
So you've been here now since 1991,
yes.
You got married?
We are married in 1994. 7 years.
Where was your husband born?
He born in China too, same village. We are in a small village. It's next to the seaside, very beautiful village. So now, you know, we try to make a best in here with the kids, you know. So they grow up here, they need a good education here. So, you know, we try to do best we can.
Mm-hmm. You were telling Donna something about, what was the place that you were talking about, where she had been?
Near
some river or something?
I'm sorry.
She was talking to you about having been in China at that place.
On the Guangzhou? She's been in the Guangzhou. It's a very big city. Uh-huh. Very big and business city, you know, very beautiful. Mm-hmm. Yes. And we came from like a Fuzhou, the last two Guangzhou is very beautiful city too. Yeah.
Do you miss not being there? Have you gone back at all?
Only one time, because when we came here, all the family moved.
I see.
So actually, you know, have nothing, still have the grandma, you know, grandparents in China, but I went back one time in 1992. So from that time, I didn't go back yet. Mm-hmm. I miss there. I have a lot of friends, but in here, you know, I try to be American, but sometimes it's very hard. It's very hard, you know. So, but I still have some friends, you know, good friends, and they are in Highland Park, you know. I know that almost everybody in the Highland Park.
That's the whole idea of this program, for people who don't know you to know you. Mm-hmm. That's what we like to do. Mm-hmm. And I know you're busy with your store, but with the children, what do you like to do
here? We wanted to give them a good education, you know, and good life in America. So they born here. So they had to be American. So we try to do anything we can do best for the kids. Uh-huh. Yeah.
I asked you, and I was surprised, where you had studied English, because you do very well. And you told me what?
Yeah, I picked up the English from the street. From the street, from the talk, you know, when we have business in here, so we like to talk. I like to talk, you know, to talk to the people. And when I say something wrong, so most people, they correct me, you know. Yeah, so they give me the words, what can I say? Sometimes I ask the people, I say right or I did right. Yeah, it's very hard, very hard. When we came here in 1991, like the first couple months, nobody can understand what I'm talking about. Yes. So, yeah, I heard, you know, same words, but the pronunciation is different. When we learned English, well, I did learn English from the school, from high school and college, but the pronunciation is different. I don't know why. Maybe it's like English, you know.
Because the instructor learned possibly in an English school or in England or whatever.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
That's what you hear.
Mm-hmm. But now I still pick up English. Yeah, still need to improve my English. Yeah.
At home, do the children speak both Chinese and English?
Yeah. Yes. They speak Chinese and English, but most time they pick up English better than Chinese. They pick up quick.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. That's very good. Mm-hmm. It comes in very handy, being able to speak more than one language.
Oh, yeah.
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 And English is one of the most difficult languages.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Very, very
mm-hmm.
much.
Mm-hmm.
But you do it. Do you have a chance to do anything with the children, any kind of sports, or theater or anything, you know, that they like or you like?
Oh, yeah. We try whatever my daughter or my son, when they grow up and they interesting to do something, you know, we like to help her. Like now my daughter wants to learn the piano.
Uh-huh.
So we send her to the, you know, the class. So she learned the piano, she learned the dancing, you know, and drawing. Very busy all week. Yeah. We wanted to, you know, make a good place for the kids, you know, whatever they like, whatever they wanted to do. So I try to do the good thing.
Do either you or your husband either play an instrument or anything like that? Did you study music ever?
No, not really. No. But my husband wanted to go back to college. He went back a year to the college in the Middle State College.
What do you want to study?
He's studying business.
Business. How far did he go in school up to now?
Now he finished. Now he finished, you know, for only a year yet. Only a year.
Still got a year to go.
Mm-hmm.
Boy, that must keep you both very busy.
Oh, yeah.
Between when you're
grandma.
In the store.
Grandma.
Grandma,
yes.
Do you all live together?
Yes, in Highland Park. Yeah.
In Highland Park?
Yes.
That must be nice.
Yes.
And everybody's together. Hmm?
Thank you.
Right?
Yes. Yes. You know.
That's wonderful. You know, the time goes so fast. Speaking of you, there's so many things that I could still ask you, but we won't have the time. And maybe we'll have an opportunity to invite your husband to come, and we'll have the two of you.
Sure.
And it'll
sure.
bounce back and forth.
Sure, sure. I like to tell the people, too. You know, I'd like to let the people know more about us, you know, about my store, about us.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
What would you like to happen with your store? Is that the end of everything, or is that the beginning?
We're just beginning.
The beginning.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Oh, yeah. That is just great. I'm so glad you were able to make it.
You Thank know? You. Thank you for inviting me. I like to let the people know.
Uh-huh. Anyway, I'll invite your husband and you back another time, and
okay.
we'll talk some more.
Okay. 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 Thank you.
I told you it was going to be interesting. It just flew by. And next thing we'll do, we'll invite Lin Yang's husband, and we'll hear his side and get more. In the meantime, look forward to our next program, and just keep paying attention. And we want more volunteers, because there are so many interesting people here at Highland Park. So again, thank you very much for tuning in.